There are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Logitech after the company smashed earnings expectations and raised its full-year guidance. Shares of the Swiss computer parts maker soared over 8% in midday trading. Also in focus, shares of British bank Barclays after it signaled major cost cuts to mitigate the effects of margin pressure from competition in the savings market. Barclays shares tumbled nearly 6% on that news. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Hermès. The luxury brand sales numbers rose in the third quarter, beating expectations and outshining rivals. This led its stock to rise 2% in midday trade. We're also keeping an eye on shares of Coca-Cola after it beat earnings estimates and raised its outlook. Coca-Cola shares are up over 1.5% before the bell. Asian markets ended Tuesday trade mostly higher. Most markets in the region saw a rebound after days of losses over geopolitical uncertainty. Australia's ASX 200 and the South Korean KOSPI index snapped a three-day losing streak as traders avoided bets ahead of economic data expected to offer clues to the next steps by the U.S. Federal Reserve. The Hong Kong Hang Seng, meanwhile, shed over 1% as it caught up to yesterday's losses after a one-day holiday. In Japan, Mitsubishi Motors saw its stock climb 1.7% after it announced it will invest up to 200 million euros in the new electric vehicle unit of French carmaker Renault. Here at home, the PSE index extended its route to five sessions. First Metro Investments' Christina Ulang not too optimistic about the market's year-end prospects.
But now I think the range would be in the closer to the 6,003 level and then potentially some overshoot towards 6,005. But it's going to be a difficult uphill climb because of the geopolitical tension ramping up and the yield cutting of course, by the BSP being pushed back towards later in 2024. So all of this, there have been big changes and shifting of expectations.
It looks like an off-cycle rate hike could be happening soon. That's according to Philippine Central Bank Governor Eli Remolona Jr. Headline inflation accelerated in the last 2 months, settling at 6.1% in September. Now, this brought the year-to-date average to 6.6%, and that's way above the government's 2-4% target range.
The data says inflation will go up very significantly, and there's a risk of affecting inflationary expectations. Mm-hmm. Then we may go for an off-cycle hike as early as Thursday, entering next week.
The BSP has hiked borrowing rates by 425 basis points since last year, bringing its benchmark rate to 6.25%. For those looking for electric vehicles, Tesla now has a showroom and service center in the Philippines. Let's get more details on that from Jackie Pasquale. He joins us on the line. Jackie?
Hi, good evening, Ron. Tesla, through its distributor, opened a showroom and service center along EDSA in Mandaluyong. Various electric vehicle models are on sale. Its distributor, EV Solutions, is confident of the growth of the electric vehicle segment in the country, particularly EVs in the high-end market. EV Solutions CEO Ralph Kalinisan said, though there are still challenges in the EV sector, such as the lack of charging stations, he is still optimistic EVs will be the future in the country. He is also relying on President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s statement on having 50% of cars on the road electric by 2040. Tesla cars are priced from 4 million pesos up to 10 million pesos depending on the model. But Kalinisan said it is still cheaper to operate an EV, saying that a full charge of Tesla is worth 600 pesos, but a full tank gas is worth 4 to 5,000 pesos. And the range, he said, of a Tesla is roughly 500 kilometers. He added that unlike some high-end vehicles, which would need 1 to 2 years of waiting period before the owner gets his unit, several Tesla models are available now and ready to be sold. Kalinisan said that in the long run, EVs are worth the investment. They just need the help of government to establish more charging stations and give more incentives. And that's the latest. Ron, back to you.
Jackie Pascual with that story. Thanks, Jackie.